Hey, this is Ralph, and in this video I want to show you how to add a custom font to your PowerPoint presentations. Okay, so I've got a really simple PowerPoint presentation here, and if I activate, for instance, the title slide, of course we've got tons of fonts available, but let's say you wanted to go through and add a brand new font. So what I'm going to have, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to jump out to the web real quick, and if I just did a Google search for free fonts, one of the sites that comes up pretty often is 1001freefonts.com. This other one here, DeFont, is pretty good, and I haven't used Font Squirrel, but any of these free font sites, you'll find a nice variety of fonts to choose from. So over here at 1001 Free Fonts, you can go through, there's a bunch of categories of various fonts and things like that. And so there's tons of fonts to choose from. I'm going to grab this one because it really stands out, this D. Puntillas. And I'm going to click the download option. And it's going into my downloads folder. It's D. Puntillas Zip. And I think I'm going to take this though, and I'm just going to move it over to my desktop real quick just so you can kind of see it from there. So I now have this font zipped up on my desktop. What I'm going to do is I'll just right click on that. I'm going to extract it. Extract. And whenever you unzip a zip file for a font, you're going to find quite a few variations in there. Some fonts might give you several variations. Some might give you, you know, six or more. I was looking at one earlier. It had, I think, probably about 10 different variations. For instance, if you double click on one, you'll actually see an example of how that font looks, and there is an install button right up there. So I can see this is kind of a hollow version of that one, and I'll just double click on one of these others. Here's a filled in version of that one. So you got a few choices, and of course you could select several of them and take care of them all at once. I think I'm just going to get the first one here. I'm going to right click on this TTF, which is a true type font file, right click on that, and I'm going to choose the install option. It'll go super quick. It's already done. Now, as soon as you install a font, it may or may not be readily available in your program. So if I go to my PowerPoint, which I had left open, and I scroll down and I go into the D's for my font, and it's not jumping out as to me as being available in here, that D. Puntillas font. So I don't notice it. So no problem. I'm going to go ahead and close PowerPoint. And I'm going to open it back up. In fact, let me go back to my presentation that I was just using. So now I'm back into my presentation. And if I click on this, go to my fonts now, there I see it, D. Puntillas Lace. And if I choose that font is now being used on my presentation. So that was pretty easy. Now, if I want to use this particular font for all of my slide titles, probably the most practical way to do that would be to head over to View, and then I'm going to go into Slide Master. I'm going to go up to my main master slide here. I'll click on the border of my placeholder, the border of my title placeholder, Home Ribbon. I'll change that font out to the D. Puntillas, and there we go. So now this particular font family is going to be applied to all of my slide titles. I can go ahead and get back over Slide Master, close that master view. So now whenever I create a new slide, there we go, each new slide is going to have that particular font. Now, when you use a custom font in a PowerPoint presentation, or a Word document for that matter, you might want to go an extra step and make sure that font is embedded in the particular file. What I mean by that is I'm going to click on the File menu, and I'm going to go to Options, and particularly, I'm going to look at the Save Options. So File, Options, Save Options. Let me scroll this up a little bit. And near the bottom of this Save Options dialog box, there's an option to embed fonts in the file. Well, if you use a fancy custom font on your presentation, and then you show that presentation on a computer that doesn't have that font installed, you're going to have some trouble. So what you can do is you can embed fonts in the file, and that gives you two choices. I can embed only the characters used in the presentation. Notice it reduces file size, and that would be good if you were just going to be showing your presentation on a, let's say, a foreign computer, a computer you don't know that well. Or you could choose to embed all characters of the font. So, and they even mention here, it's best for editing by other people. So if you still think you might need to add some content to the PowerPoint in that unusual font, then you want to do the second option. Keep in mind, this option is going to greatly add to the file size of your PowerPoint. Let me show you this real quick. I'll go ahead and embed. I'm going to embed all characters. I'll click OK. I'm going to do a file save as. I'm going to save to my desktop. And I'll just give this a slightly different name. There we go. So I now have these two files saved. Got my presentation title, my presentation title 4. The first one is without the font being embedded before I even really installed it. And if I head over to properties, I can see that this font is under a megabyte at 668K. With my embedded font, we're up over a megabyte. So quite a bit of a difference in just using that embedded font feature. But you're going to really appreciate having that if you're using your custom font on your PowerPoint. So download a font from a font website, unzip it, right-click on the TTF file to install, use that font in your presentation, but don't forget to go to the File, Options, Save Options, and embed that font in the file.